got a week of travel and want to enjoy it, but also not undermine my process as it's early days. Now this is a good one, because again it goes back to that all or nothing thing. The all or nothing approach is, right, I've got the plan and I will carve life around the plan. Now that's not sustainable for most of us, because what happens is life happens, as I've said before. And in this case, another client question, travel was coming, and it wasn't just travel as in work, well it was work related travel, but it was also meeting up with colleagues, friends, and inevitably there was going to be socializing, there was going to be buffet style lunches during meetings, there was going to be grabbing this, that and the other, and there was going to be evening meals and drinks on a night. So if you've just started on a plan in the all or nothing mindset, your options become very, very limited, as in stuff it, I'll just go and I'll be like a monk and I'll be rigid. What's the chances of surviving that, or what's going to be the cost to you in order to hold your will like steel through that? Or don't go, which again has its consequences. So for me, the more flexible approach, the sprout sweater approach, that longer term approach is, okay, reality. This is, how do we make this life proof? How do we make the plan fit around the things that are going to happen? Because this is a learning process, because it's early days, this is one thing, there's going to be others, there'll be Christmas, there'll be holidays, there'll be other meetings, there'll be unexpected this, that and the others. How do I use this as a bit of a learning process? So anyway, that aside is the learning that we get from it helps us get better at the future. But the approach that I suggested here is, and that we discussed, is okay, so it's about 6 days away, 6 days of travel, being away and that unpredictable socializing, etc. So let's look at the plan. So month in, doing okay, doing kind of on course, but I know that this is going to have an impact. Okay, so let's not take the micro view of each of the weekly weigh-ins, etc. Let's lengthen it out and look at the average over the month, and look at how we can both prepare for that week by sticking to some of those sprout-sized habits, rituals, routines, maybe add a little bit of exercise in to add a little bit more, or walking to just add in that energy deficit so that we can prepare for it. Look at what we can do afterwards to then average it out. Don't weigh yourself directly after you come back, because, and that is a call, you know, I'm not being rigid about it, but what I did with the client was agree that perhaps that would, the effect of seeing what weight went on would have had more damaging effect than motivational effect. So leave it another week and let's see what we can do in the week after. And during the week, look for opportunities. So don't be rigid. We want to enjoy them, we want to enjoy yourself, we want to enjoy the socializing and what have you, but what opportunities do you have during the week? And this is where we talked about pulling on a couple of levers on the energy in side in terms of diet. So the levers are, you can sort of, if you talk about energy in, energy out balance, how do I reduce the energy in or moderate the energy in particular over this time, using the levers of perhaps time restricted, calorie restriction, monitoring calories, or diet restriction, eliminating a particular or not consuming a particular type of food or a particular thing, whether it's sugar or carb or whatever. I mean, there's lots of different variations. I'm not necessarily recommending any, but it's about what is likely to work and support you the most in your time away. And what we discussed was perhaps a bit of a blend, that perhaps the time restriction could be useful because it might mean I could extend my fast overnight, the breakfast, to a little bit later and even skip it and count it as lunch. And that might moderate things. The lunch, work on lunches where possible, maybe three out of the six being a little bit more healthy where possible, taking people off and proactively saying let's go off and find something healthy, and then allowing, so that time restriction coupled with a bit of calorie restriction, the healthier choices, coupled with perhaps exchanging a couple of things where you might then say, right, rather than beer, I'll have a spirit. And this is not me endorsing this. This is the discussions that I've had with the client around what would work. Now, this is not necessarily going to work for everybody, but it's about being flexible. And this is the point about the planning and the thinking ahead. You have a number of levers to pull. Rather than expecting to rigidly stick to something, let's change it up. Let's move. Well, the time restriction is something I could use there, because naturally I might just, you know, I might skip breakfast and it'll work for me, because I'm going to be straight into things, I'll be busy, occupied, etc. That'll work. So what would work in that situation that perhaps might not work back in the home situation? And all we're talking about is mitigating it without suppressing that enjoyment, but also without necessarily overly undoing the work that we've done. But being real, there's going to be an impact of that few days. But that's life. We're playing the longer game and treating it as the longer game. So again, this was a conversation. I think it's useful just to sort of see in terms of the thinking around it, that it takes a bit of thought, but it's not about being rigid. It's not about beating ourselves or even being defeatist and thinking, oh, well, it's a write-off. The week's coming up, it's a write-off. What could you do that could just help it be a little bit healthier than perhaps it would have been if you weren't on this journey? And have a think about that if that's something for you. And again, drop me your line, Dave at Restless Midlife, if you have any thoughts or questions around that.